Aside from being COVID-19 frontliners, members of the Philippine Medical Association are also making the rounds of typhoon-ravaged areas to provide free medical consultations. To talk to us more about that, we have PMA President Dr. Benito Atienza. Good morning, Doctor, and thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Mika.
Doctors on boats have been doing a lot of help for our kababayans. How and when did your advocacy start? And from there, how did it progress up to now?
The doctors have been ongoing since 2009. Mm-hmm. We have served our kababayans during the typhoon of Yolanda in Leyte, Undoy typhoon aftermath in Marikina, in other parts of Laguna in that year. And now, during the three successive storms, we had lots of floods in the area. Actually, we're on our way going back to Manila from Cagayan. We served the some communities there, flooded areas in Cagayan yesterday, mm-hmm. With the help of the Philippine Coast Guard.
Mm-hmm. All right, Doctor, may I know, all the doctors who are here in the program, are they volunteers?
Yes, this is a volunteer mission of the Philippine Medical Association. Mm-hmm. There consists of 15 doctors who went there from Manila and from the Cagayan Valley Medical Society. With the help of the Coast Guard, we are provided with two boats going to the area. Kasi flooded talaga yung area. This is an area with a rice corn field became like a lake, submerged in water.
Doctor, for the campaigns that you do, do you have to have at least an or do you have to organize with the local government units or the national government before you can start offering relief?
This is coordinated with the Philippine Coast Guard, national, and then with the local PNP, Philippine National Police Region 2, with General Nieve. Mm-hmm. They are providing us with the logistics. Mm-hmm. And the Philippine Coast Guard provides us with the bus and two coasters going there, the area.
Mm-hmm. Sir,
and two boats, rubber boats.
All right, Doctor, we're seeing pictures on the screen of your doctors helping our affected kababayans. What kind of help, aside from the immediate need of food packs and water, does Doctors on Boats offer?
Doctors offer the medical assistance. We bring medicines, mm-hmm. like ointments for their wounds, mm-hmm. then antifungal, mm-hmm. then capsules for the of medicine, then multivitamins for the elderly, then the package, mm-hmm. we give them the box, includes the hygiene kit. The hygiene kit includes, mm-hmm. that cotton, alcohol, soap, toothbrush, and powder. Mm-hmm. Then we also give them the clothes, mm-hmm. used clothes, and food like canned goods, canned sardines with pack noodles, and 2 kilos of rice, mm-hmm. for each pack.
Mm-hmm. Doctor,
and we were able to serve more than 60 patients yesterday. Mm-hmm. In that area. Mm-hmm. And we distributed other repack foods for we served 3 towns, mm-hmm. nearby Tugigaraw area.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Atienza, when you go to areas that are ravaged by, let's say, calamities like this, do you also do on-site consultations for our kababayans?
Yes. We call that face-to-face, mm-hmm. consultations, but, mm-hmm. we're wearing our PPE, the complete PPE with mask, mm-hmm. with face shield, mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And we also offer our telemedicine, the DocPH, mm-hmm. to everyone there, the area that you cannot access the face-to-face consultation.
You've already mentioned DocPH, Dr. Atienza, which is an online consultation. Can you tell us more about it, please? Like, do you do that in tandem with on face-to-face consultations, or is it supposed to be scheduled on areas you cannot reach?
Yes, yes. This DocPH is a telemedicine teleconsultation, a project of the Philippine Medical Association, coordinating with the data privacy organization, with the Beta Sigma fraternity. Ito yung mga nag-graduate na mga doctors. Even outside the Philippines, they can join as a volunteer doctor in the DocPH. Even at night, they can serve the our kababayan. Starts at 9 o'clock to 9 p.m. every day. Started since April 9th on the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. Go to the FB page and click the DocPH.
Can you repeat that again, Doctor, the website we can go to?
DocPH.
All right.
They just click that, type the DocPH in the FB page, lalabas na yun doon. Then they click consultation. Consult. In this format, they will answer some questions, the details of the symptoms, then the last three questions is related to COVID. And if they answer in related to COVID, they will be referred to a hospital. It's not COVID-related. A doctor specialist will answer them. We have doctors specialists in pediatrics, obstetrics, surgery, different specialization.
All right. This is a good way to at least have an immediate help, you know, for our Filipino families who are needing medical assistance. Now, Dr. Atienza, the country has been ravaged the past few months. May we know where are you going next for doctors on boats? What part of the country are you going to next? And also for all those who would want to help, doctors who would want to volunteer, Filipinos who would want to give donations, how can we help?
Yes, we have full coordination. We have they can send the donation through box, and we have that through our FB page. They can post it, then they can we have lots of donations from including the private corporation like Mercury Drug Foundation donated 5% or more of medicines, including the hygiene kits we gave to the blood victims. Another drug company, local drug company, Roy Med, gave 474,000 worth of medicine, including face shield and gloves and other like syringes. And they can bring them to the Philippine Medical Association compound at North Avenue in front of Dynoma beside SM North.
All right. With that, I will let you go, Dr. Benito Atienza, the president of the Philippine Medical Association. Thank you so much for your time, sir, and God bless.
Thank you, Rica.